Welcome to the video for section 50 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek Unintensive course. We're going to talk about independent subjunctives. You'll find this in Hansen and Quinn on pages 145 to 146 and in the appendix on pages 714 to 715. So far, you've only used the subjunctive mood in subordinate or dependent clauses, in order that or if clauses that cannot stand on their own. They are subordinate to or depend on another independent clause. But Greek also uses the subjunctive in some independent clauses, ones that can stand on their own. We're going to look at three kinds of independent subjunctive sentences in this video. The first is called the hortatory subjunctive, which Greek uses to exhort some action. It can use the present or aorist subjunctive and is in the first person. The negative is may. The default translation is let me verb or let us verb. For instance, tus neanias didaxo, which means let me teach the young men. This could, of course, be the future indicative, I will teach the young men, so context will have to tell you which to choose. Here's another example. Ton polemon me paumen, which means, let us not stop the war. You can encourage yourself or a group of people with you to do anything with the hortatory subjunctive. Our second independent subjunctive is the deliberative subjunctive, and just as it sounds, Greek uses it to consider a course of action. It can use the present or aorist subjunctive. Tense is only about aspect, and it will be in the first person. The negative is may, all of which probably looks very familiar from the hortatory subjunctive. What distinguishes it from the hortatory subjunctive is that it's a question, so there will be a question mark. The default translation is, am I to verb, or are we to verb? For instance, tus neanias didaxo, should I teach the young men? And should is a perfectly good colloquial English translation for the deliberative subjunctive as well. Again, this could also be the future indicative, I will teach the young men, or actually as a question, will I teach the young men? So context will have to tell you. Another example, ton polemon me paumen, are we not to stop the war? With the deliberative subjunctive, you can mull over any possible action. Our last independent subjunctive is the prohibitive subjunctive, and just as it sounds, Greek uses it to tell someone not to do something. It can be the aorist subjunctive only, and it will be in the second person. It can be singular or plural. The negative is may, but of course it's always negative. And the default translation is do not verb. An example, me tus neanias didaxes. Don't teach the young men. Or me ton polemon pauseta. Don't stop the war. You can prohibit any action with the prohibitive subjunctive. We'll talk about how to command people to do things later in the course. As I warned you when I introduced you to the subjunctive, you still need to see what a subjunctive verb is doing before you can translate it. Now, in addition to purpose clauses and conditional clauses, you can add these three independent clauses to the sorts of things that subjunctive can do. Once you've determined that the main verb of a sentence is subjunctive, which means that it's an independent subjunctive, here's what to check for to decide which of the three it is. If it's first person with no question mark, it's hortatory, let me verb or let us verb. If it's first person with a question mark, it's deliberative, should I verb or should we verb? And if it's got a may, is in the second person, and is aorist, it's prohibitive, and you translate don't verb. That should set you in pretty good stead to recognize independent subjunctives in your exercises and readings.